Welcome to Warrior Wednesday. It's May 20th. We are officially in Gemini season. So for all my Geminis out there, if there's a Gemini, if you're a Gemini and you're in the house, comment with hashtag Gemini so I can say hello to my Gemini. My Geminis are my fellow air signs. I'm an Aquarius. And so any fellow air signs want to see ya. And if you're another sign, comment with whatever your sign is, hashtag Taurus. We're in Taurus season, or hashtag Pisces, Scorpio, etc. So if you're on here live, give yourself some hearts and say hello so I can, you know, give you a shout out. And if you're catching the replay, comment with hashtag encore. And so I can thank you for tuning into the replay. All right. So today, this week, we're going to be covering episode 2 of how to manage your mind. If you're going crazy during this quarantine, and I know a lot of states have not opened up yet, whereas some other states have opened up and then closed back and then opened up, like some crazy stuff going on. Hey, Braxton, thanks for tuning in. So I wanted to cover a couple of key strategies. Last week we covered on episode 1, 2 strategies on how you can manage your mind during this quarantine experience. And today we will cover 2 other strategies for you to set yourself up to win for 2020. So if you're excited about that, give yourself some hearts so I can see you. And there may be a bit of a delay here on my end. So the 2 things we covered last week, if you did not tune in to episode 1, was the 2 R's of recognizing and redirecting. So if you did not catch episode 1, I invite you to go to my YouTube channel, which is at Zena Solomon, and you can catch the replay for episode 1 and do the mission for that, okay? So if So with that being said, we also covered what mindset is as well. So what is mindset? What is the frame of mind? How are you operating? Where are you operating from? What space are you in, etc.? So there are a couple cool quotes that I want to share with you before I jump in and share a couple of key strategies, 2 more strategies that you can implement right away that will support you in what you're up to. So the first quote is by Frank Zappa, and he says, "A mind is like a parachute. It doesn't work if it's not open." Bam, that's hashtag bam right there, okay? So if you're not open, how are you gonna like fly? You know what I'm saying? So if that resonates, let me know if that resonates. Another quote by Wayne Dyer, he says, "If you change the way you look at things, the things you look at change." So it's all about perspective. It's all about how we see things. And that goes back to what we talked about from episode 1. So the 2 strategies for you are, the first one for this week is recruit those muscles. And here's what I mean by recruiting those muscles. So you have your mental muscles, you have your physical muscles. We have like more than that as well, actually. So your mental muscle is your mental endurance, your mental toughness, your mental agility. And one thing that I found that has been so effective in managing your mind is to also manage yourself physically. So here's the opportunity. The opportunity is to give yourself a physical challenge, like, you know, going for a run, doing burpees, doing some form of physical challenge, because what you will see and what you will notice is there's a direct correlation with doing a physical activity and how you manage your mind in doing that activity. And if you're an athlete, you know exactly what I'm talking about. Like if you're running track, I used to run track, and I used to train for events, for like half marathons, etc. So it takes a level of mental toughness and mental agility to get over yourself, to be in the space of like, okay, I'm committed to this, I'm committed to growing, and I'm committed to taking that on. So that's the focus. So you get to get outside of your comfort zone. Hey, Michael, thanks for tuning in. Hey, Raphael, thanks for tuning in. So to get outside of your comfort zone, you get to focus on what your commitment is, and you also get to focus on, you know, challenging yourself physically so that you can optimize yourself mentally. Okay, so the opportunity is pick a challenge, pick something like to take yourself on physically to get in a better shape, whether it's running, whether it's hiking, whether it's burpees. I mean, I'm doing 100 burpees for 100 days. I'm currently on day 68 of 100 days. So it's been 68 days since, you know, that I've been doing 100 burpees. It's not easy, and it is a mental game every single day, every single burpee. So just saying, all right, I practice what I preach here, peeps, okay? So pick that, whatever that is for you, and share what that is. If you're here live, share what that is. And if you're catching the replay, share what that is for you physically, okay? The second thing you get to focus on is reverse engineering. So start with the end in mind. So we, in the beginning, actually the end of 2019, we had a vision. You had a vision, right? And the vision was, okay, what do I want to create in 2020? We did not see a global pandemic happening. That wasn't something that we expected, nor was it anything that, anyone was even considered in the space. So with that being said, I still invite you to go back to what your dreams and vision and goals, accomplishments, that you had set for yourself for 2020 and reconnect with them. Like, what were they? What did you want to create? What is it that you want to create? And let's create that 2020 vision for you so that you're in the space of actually making it happen. So people are creating amazing results during this time, by the way. And if you're not around those people, you get to be surrounded by people who are creating amazing results during a pandemic and not be in the breakdown with a pandemic. So that's the opportunity and that's the invitation I have for you. So are you clear about your vision? What is your vision? If you're here, share what it is. What is your vision? What are your goals? What did you want to create in 2020? What are some things that you were excited about that you wanted to create for 2020? So, and what would make 2020 a rock star year for you? What is that for you? You know? So let's focus on that. Okay. So with that being said, those are your two strategies for this week. And next week we'll cover additional strategies. So here's your mission, guys. Okay. So your mission for this week is to pick something physically that you're committed to do that'll take you in better shape, both physically, physical shape and mental shape, and ask yourself, okay, what is that thing? And what am I, and how long am I going to do it for? Am I going to do it for 30 days? Am I going to do it for 60 days? What is the time frame? So pick something, pick a challenge for yourself, get outside of your comfort zone, and invite someone to join you in the challenge, because it's much more fun when you have other people supporting you and you're also leading other people to grow together, because we're all here to grow together and elevate together as a humanity and also as consciousness. Secondly, the second part of your mission is you get to share what your vision is for 2020. What is your 2020 vision? What would make 2020 a rock star year for you? So I invite you to share so we can support you. All right. So thanks so much for tuning in. I'm going to keep this really short and I'll catch you next week, Warrior Wednesday, same time, same station, 1 o'clock Pacific, 4 o'clock Eastern. And thank you so much, guys, for tuning in. Bye. Be safe.